Well, what do you think?
New hat?
No, no, Michael. My cologne.
Is that smell coming from you?
Yes.
By choice?
Of course.
Ah, oh, see, I was just gonna go check the septic tank.
You don't like it?
No. Who are you trying to impress?
Jean Kern. She's from the valley. Very beautiful. And very rich. I have a date with her tomorrow night. You don't think my cologne will make her dislike me?
See, I think the cologne might make her unconscious. But maybe it'll wear off by tomorrow.
Hey, Michael, I think we better check the septic. Oh, hi, CC.
Neither of you have any taste.
What did I say?
Expensive.
Hey, you boy! Hey, what are you doing?
Hey, you got all this nice stuff and you can't afford to pay us?
You boy, you go now. Go get in. Ding.
We want a payment now, Dale.
No money. You go.
What are you doing here?
I stay out of this deal.
Not here. My uncle's poor.
Hey, everybody's got to give.
Yep. Lende.
That's right, Diem. Stay out of it.
I told you, not here.
Look, no money. Diem.
Why? Put it back.
Anything.
You know, we're gonna have to take him in. You understand that?
You think I enjoy talking to myself? All right, I'll talk to myself.
Boy, you sure lucked out with that judge, sending you to Michael Terry's ranch instead of a juvenile detention center.
Yes, sir. Cows, sheep, buffalo, and all the bugs that go with them. Dim, I know you'd rather stay home. Now I can make you a deal. I can talk to that judge. Change his mind about sentencing you at all. No detention center, no ranch. But to do that, you have to lose that attitude and start talking to me, son. I tell you what, I'm gonna go just down the hall and get myself a cup of coffee. And when I come back, we can resume our little chat. All right. Stay there.
All right.
I thought I told you to stay in that room.
Okay. It's all right.
No, it isn't. That's the firecracker I was telling you about. How do you expect a kid to stop displaying anti-establishment behavior when you treat him like a...
Like a tight-mouthed little punk who tried to keep the head clean off of a police officer.
Is that what he's in for?
No, he was stirring it up before the police came along.
They caught him fighting with two other punks in the middle of the street.
Who started it?
Who knows? The kid won't say a damn thing. And other than the fact that he hasn't been in school in a couple of months, he has no previous record. Those punks didn't provoke him. He's been watching too many ninja movies.
Well, something stirred him up.
Apparently, the altercation started inside his uncle's store.
Well, what happened?
The old man won't say, but it's obvious those punks are up to something.
Like what?
Well, extortion's a possibility. Could be the reason he's kept quiet. Officer on the scene saw this guy standing by. Name's Troy. Police have a pretty good idea his gang is into extorting protection money from immigrant store owners. He's getting away with it because people like DM's uncle won't call the police.
DM could be fighting a one-man battle.
One he can't win in a million years. He'll be home in 3 months. Probably dead 10 minutes after that.
If you can get him released in my custody and I can convince him to tell the police about the extortion, do you think you can get the charges against him dropped?
If he's telling the truth, I don't know. This kid's got an attitude.
Maybe he just doesn't like you.
And this is Michael Terry.
Hey.
You feel like telling me what happened? If you did, I think they'd let you go. What's the reason you haven't been to school for the last couple of months? Who were you fighting? What'd they do? Strong, silent type, huh?
I see what you mean.
Well, you've just had a major conversation.
Mess with him. He's got a couple of 100 pounds on you.
Somebody we know die?
No, I am going on a date.
So why the suit?
It happens to be with a very classy person. You would not understand.
And you think classy people wear suits all the time?
As a matter of fact, they do.
Well, you're gonna look pretty classy picking up your date in Fox's truck.
Ah, that is why I arranged for Gene to pick me up here.
Good plan.
Thanks. Vic? How do I look, huh?
Sure that tie goes with that shirt?
What are you looking at? Hey, China boy, what are you reading? Taekwondo. Think you know that stuff?
Yes, I do.
Gotta learn by doing it, man, not reading it. Let me see it, dude. Huh?
Don't bother me anymore.
Let me go, ya chink. Hey, Steve, oh man, leave the guy alone. Get up, Gook.
Don't call me that.
Get up!
I don't want to hurt you. I don't have a reason to.
Oh, you don't.
Why are you doing this?
Because you're a gook.
Next time, break your arm.
Come on!
Come on.
Oh! Hey, come on, man. Stop it. You're gonna break it.
You asked for it, didn't you?
That's a pretty good hold.
He jumped me, man. I was just sitting there. Yeah, I saw him. He jumped me, right? Right.
Go ahead. Say it's my fault. I don't care.
You just started using his kung fu stuff on me. I'm glad you showed.
Are you? Well, I was standing down at the bottom of the stairs, and I heard this entire conversation, and I heard enough racist comments out of you.
No way,
and
Michael!
I don't like that stuff.
I'm telling you, it was him.
He defended himself just like I would have. I'm warning you, Stephen. You're one step away.
I'm sorry.
Don't you guys have some work to do?
That was pretty impressive.
I warned him.
I know you did. Were you really going to break his arm?
No. Stephen is like a moth. He bothers, but he can't hurt.
No. What can? How about a guy named Troy? He runs a gang in your neighborhood that's in the extortion business. You know who I'm talking about? Well, I'd really like to help you, Jim. I know you don't think I can, but I'll grow on you.
Why do you want to help me?
Because I think you need it.
Hi. You want something, mister?
No, I'm Michael Terry. Jim's at my ranch.
Jim, come home?
Well, I'm afraid he's got a court order. But I think he should be here.
When Tim be here?
Well, I was hoping you could tell me something about him. Who his friends are, or what he likes.
No, you go.
I can help him.
No, nothing.
Tim doesn't seem to be the type of kid that would get in trouble.
No, nothing.
But he can't come back until you tell the police about these extortion gangs.
No police.
They can help.
No one help.
For DM's sake.
No police. You go, please. You go.
Okay.
Can you justify your actions? Can you give me justify this violence? Can you give me one good reason?
One good reason.
Justify your actions. Can you give me one?
problem, Frank?
No.
Is this Thorns, you know? It's Thorns.
Hey!
You know. Iry, one moment, my friend. Hey!
Well, I hope I didn't scare him off. How you doing, man?
Struggling. Struggling in the marketplace. You?
One of my kids is in trouble. He joined a gang. What do you know about the local street gangs?
I always work alone.
Well, this one's into extortion. It's run by a guy named Troy.
No way, man. Try not into gangs.
Is he a friend of yours?
Let's say we know each other.
What can you tell me about him?
I haven't seen Troy since we were young and I was foolish. But I could visit our old friend and check him out for you.
I'd appreciate that. He doesn't sound like the type of guy you want to mess with.
Troy, don't scare me. I'll call you, man, don't worry.
The ranch is beautiful.
Oh, we like it here.
How long ago did you buy it?
How long? Oh, years.
Didn't a fellow named Kennard used to own this place a few years back?
Two years. Oh, it seems longer, like 3 years. I love the land, you know.
So do I. And I especially love the picnic basket you had your chef prepare for. What was his name again?
Michael.
Oh, yes, Michael. You must have him cook dinner for us sometime.
Oh, he would be very surprised to hear you say that.
It must be hard to cook for delinquents all day.
Well, actually, most of them do appreciate good food.
Where are they all?
The kids? At this time of night, usually they are helping me out in the kitchen. Helping me by helping him. Yeah.
You are a wonder, Cece. Opening up your ranch to delinquent children.
It has its rewards. The knowledge that I have helped a troubled kid.
Hi, Cece. Is this your date?
Is this one of your delinquents?
We just call them kids, man. I work here. Vic.
Gene. So, how long have you worked for Cece?
Oh, 7 years.
Two
long, long years.
He's not too hard on you, is he?
He's an inspiration. Nice to meet you, Gene.
Why don't we go into town, huh?
What's he doing?
He's sleeping. Why did you bring him here?
Would you rather he stayed in town?
No.
Things are getting serious now. And the stakes are gonna get higher and higher until you decide to speak out.
There's some things that don't concern you.
You're here now. The
This is my place. That makes it my business. If you don't want to talk to help me understand...
Leave us alone.
You can't fight something like this by yourself.
Fly. You exceed my expectations.
But I want to do something bigger.
You. Empty your pockets. We won't be able to grow bigger until we all learn respect for the organization.
When you serve time, you learn a great deal about loyalty and friendship. These are the things that bond us together. We're tested all our lives about who is loyal and who is not. In prison, we had this little game that helped us find these things out. Do you want to play? Your cigarette, please. Try to believe that we want to keep our arms pressed together against the fire, rather than let the other face it alone. Did well. I believe you are my friend. From now on, anyone caught stealing from us will be visited by his friends during the night.
Hey, someone's coming.
Get back to me.
Kong, Dung Noi.
Không đọc, không đọc. Tôi sẽ nói mọi dân.
Đừng nói.
Tôi đừng nói biết.
I will say nothing.
Hey, what's going on?
Nothing.
Tôi đừng nói biết.
Chắc là con.
Please, help them.
Are you ready to talk?
Yes, talk. Tell everything.
It is between us.
Yo, Troy, anybody home?
Ben.
Nice office.
Ben, I don't believe it. I knew you were coming to see me, but I didn't expect to see you so soon.
Yeah? Well, one of your little friends was kind enough to give me your address. I was in the neighborhood, so...
Have a seat.
Could use a few pictures. Maybe a nice plant or two.
What can I do for you?
I'll come to that, man. I haven't seen you in a while.
5 years.
So what you been up to?
I should ask you the same.
I'm in business, man.
Same here?
Well, actually, I'm looking to get in on some action.
Now that sounds like the line of an undercover cop. Are you a cop now, Pin?
Not my style, man. No. The fact is, I heard on the street you had a good thing going.
Well, sorry. I don't see much action anymore. I was in jail for a while, you know.
You? No.
Yeah. Funny, That's where I really suspected I'd run into you. The point is, I'm clean now. So if you want action, you'll have to look somewhere else.
Come on, Troy, cut me in.
Nice to see you, Pin.
Trouble?
No. Nothing to worry about. Gaza, follow him. See if he meets up with the police. Fly, have you found out yet who that man was that helped Dow after you visited his store?
No, not yet, but he wasn't a cop.
How do you know? Did you ask him?
No.
And what if? What if he works for the police and Dow tells him what you look like?
What should I do then?
Use your imagination. Diem and his uncle don't want to deal with us. They fight us. So you have to learn how to think like a businessman. You're not an adult. You can't go to jail like I can.
You mean kill?
Finally, you learn. On the other hand, you still have to find him.
Don't worry. We'll find them.
Oh, I'm sure you will.
You didn't find anything?
Yeah, I know. It looked like I was losing my touch. He thought I was a cop.
You?
You believe it? What's the world coming to? Anyway, at least I know he was lying through his teeth.
Yeah, well. That's better than nothing, I guess.
Oh, yeah, the slimy dude is up to something, all right. I'll keep asking around for you.
Yeah, do that. Thanks, buddy.
Morning.
Hi, Vic. Where's Cece?
Actually, he didn't make it home last night.
The little devil.
Who's gonna cook breakfast?
Don't look at me, I can't cook.
Great.
Well,
warm up the frying pan, Vic. You and me are gonna cook pancakes.
What's this, karate?
Taekwondo.
Bet you can really kick some butt with that stuff when you feel like it.
Taekwondo is for discipline. Confidence and respect.
Right. I could use a little of that.
Why don't you learn?
Me? How? I'm stuck here.
So am I. Come here. Remember the bunkhouse when you tried to punch me? Yeah. Watch. My fist. Take your right hand, put it there. Take this hand, no, a little lower. Okay, now push and roll my arm. Good, a little harder.
Yeah.
Good. Try it again.
Hey!
Good.
All right, you guys, knock it off.
It's okay, Mike, he's just showing me.
I'm sorry, man. It looked like you guys were... Well, maybe I can wait till after breakfast, huh?
Yeah, maybe. Uncle.
Check this out. Come here.
That's great, Steve. Let's go have breakfast.
I need a little work on that one.
What were you trying to do, anyway?
Break your arm?
Well, in that case, it does need a little work, yeah.
Fine, ya, no kong. My uncle wants to know if this is your home.
Yeah, me and the bank. But I want you to think of it as your home, too, as long as you need it.
Chumun on long one, cat.
Ah, thought lam. Lung lung waha.
He's impressed with the size of your ranch.
Well, there's a lot here to share.
him, I share home. He learn school, be doctor.
Are you studying to be a doctor?
Yes, someday. My uncle has great dreams for us.
I bet. I guess you'd hate to disappoint him. You know, you can stay together if you tell the police all you know about the gangs.
I told you to leave him out of this.
No, no police.
No police. Right. I think we should have a talk, starting with the subject of school.
You want to help? Let me go home. My uncle needs me. I am his family, and that is all we need.
Wait.
Michael.
Sissy, where have you been?
I can't explain. What stinks in here?
Pancakes.
Pancakes? What, were you cooking pancakes on the barbecue?
I can't talk about it right now.
Michael, I want you to meet someone. This is Jean.
So you're Michael.
Yeah.
How about one of your omelets?
My what?
Cece's told me all about your culinary specialties. Isn't he a darling?
It's nothing, really.
You know, I keep forgetting that, that I'm
the chef.
The chef, and, you're the...
Boss.
Boss. Sir. I'm just going to get some groceries. I'll need some money.
Money?
Yeah, a couple of $100 should be enough.
Well, I'm a little short right now.
I'll get it from you later.
Of course.
What about our omelets?
Well, I'm a little rushed right now. Maybe my boss will whip one up for you.
Cooks, they can be so temperamental.
Just what do you do all day if you don't go to school?
None of your business.
Well, I think I know what you do. Yeah.
Where are you gonna go?
Let me go!
Detroit? Is that who you're trying to protect?
No!
You don't want to talk to the police about the gang because you're in the gang.
Troy's my friend.
You don't need to belong to a gang to have a friend.
And nobody else gives me a chance.
Nobody's going to give you a chance until you give yourself one. They're not your friends.
You don't understand. People still think I'm a foreigner here.
I know it can't be easy, man.
Everyone thought I was part of a gang anyway. What would the difference be if I joined one?
They tried to steal from you.
Look what they did to your uncle. I know it must be incredibly difficult living in a new country, but you're not gonna get what you need from a street gang.
Damn. Gang?
Kong Fai Vey.
Gang, very bad.
It's not true.
It's my fault.
No.
Them lonely.
It's my fault. It's not your fault, Uncle. I joined them to protect us, so they wouldn't hurt us. I thought they wouldn't touch us if I joined them. I thought they were friends.
But I, your friend.
I think it's time we talk to the police.
I talk. Tim?
Take us home. And I will talk.
Too hard.
I'll try not to. You are so beautiful.
What the hell do you think you're doing?
I can explain.
You don't have to. We know what you're up to.
How are you gonna get out of this one, boss?
Well, I,
We could always leave town.
What?
Michael will pack a lunch for you.
You are right. I am crazy. But you saw her. You met her. She is wonderful. What was I to say to her, huh? I am a cook and dishwasher for delinquent children.
Is that all you think you are?
No, of course not, but...
Cece, if you're not happy with who you are, how do you expect to be happy with Jean?
No, leave it. I want Reed and the police to see this place exactly the way it is. Might help us get these charges dropped.
Then we come home.
Yeah, if you can call it that right now.
This is what happened after they took me away?
No. If you were here, this probably would have happened. Plus, you might have been killed.
Not a chance.
But I happen to know where I think I could get a carload of kids to come into the city and help you clean up.
They wouldn't want to help us.
Well, it'd have to be some kind of a deal. I mean, they'd come in and help you clean up, and you'd go out and give them taekwondo lessons, for instance.
Look out!
Sir, Dr. Terry's come to town.
And Philip Reed is late.
Troy sure did a number on this place.
I guess the news must be out.
It is now. The good part is, Dim's gonna put those guys away just as soon as... Where is he?
Chased after one of them.
That's just great. You get him to talk so he won't get killed. And you let him go running off to try and do exactly that?
We'll find him.
How?
Pin.
Hey, call me here. Michael, this is very bad for my image, you know.
I don't care about your image right now.
Apparently not.
Troy just tried to kill Michael.
One of my kids went after him. I gotta know where he is.
All right, I'll tell you.
No, show me. Get in, Reed.
Let's police go in first.
I'm going in now.
That's what the police are here for.
I'm going in now. Come with me or get out of my way.
All right, all right.
Hey, man, I'm not waiting for no police.
I'm going with you. You make me crazy. You know that?
You missed.
I did?
Haven't you missed us, too?
Now it's my turn.
Wait. Wait, Dan. We're your friends.
No, you're not.
We took you in.
You stole from my family.
That was a mistake. We can forget all of that now.
He's your strongest. Look what I did to him. Don't try to stop me.
Dan, trust me.
Tried to destroy my family.
That's what you'll be doing if you use that knife. What about your uncle?
Okay, everybody up against the wall.
Move! Move!
Okay.
You over there. Is my uncle all right?
He's fine. Thanks to you, he'll be all right. Oh, man. I knew you were an undercover cop.
I'm not, man.
So what you cause now, Michael? Ruin my reputation.
See you too, Cyrano.
Oh.
Cece, I'm sorry it's so late.
It's all right. Gina, I must talk
Cece,
with you.
Cece, I have to talk to you too. I saw someone today, someone I haven't seen in a long time.
Who?
My husband, Cece. He just walked right up to the door and we started talking. We spoke like we hadn't done in years. I care very much about you. But if I have a chance with my husband...
Really, you don't need to explain.
You're probably too busy taking care of this ranch of yours for romance anyway.
Yes. It would have been nice to make time.
I'm sorry. Goodbye, Cece.
Goodbye, Jean.
Date. How about a game of chin?
You hate cards. I'm all right. Thanks, Vic.
Hi, guys.
Michael.
Don't ask.
Chin?
Yeah, sure. Deal me in.
Sure thing, boss.
I'm the boss again, am I?
Don't ask, huh?
Yeah.
looking at my cards.
No, I wasn't.
Yes, you were. You were looking at my cards. How can we play cards if you are looking at my cards? Michael, he was looking at my cards.
You're being paranoid.
You're cheating.
Thank you.